So this cortex is that, it is that outer cortex. After that outer cortex, at the center point, it is known as that vascular tissue. At the center, so it is known as that xylem, and it is surrounded by that phloem. So it is that phloem part, it is known as that xylem. Okay, so it is that vascular tissue. So it is known as that parenchyma. It is that parenchyma. Due to the presence of parenchyma, so then plant is float on that water in that hydrophytes plants. So that is known as that parenchyma. Okay, so first it is that, it is indicated the first one is the epidermis. First layer. After the epidermis, next one is that cortex. It is known as that cortex. So outer cortex. After that, it is known as that parenchyma. So they are known as that air cavities. After that, it is that vascular tissue or vascular bundle. Vascular bundle, or it is also known as the steel. After that, it is indicated that phloem. At the center one is that xylem part. Okay, so that is that TS of that hydrilla. Okay, so in that hydrilla, mainly outer layer is known as that epidermis. So generally epidermis is that single layer. Okay, next it is a thin wall cells. It is mainly due to the presence of thin wall cells, it is mainly in that absorption of water and minerals. It is mainly involved in that absorption of water and minerals due to the presence of chloroplast. So it performing that photosynthesis process. It perform that, so photosynthesis process. Okay, so after that, okay, so generally stomata is absent. Okay, so but in which plants are freely float on the surface of water, for example in the lotus. Okay, it means in epidermis, stomata is present on that upper epidermis. Okay, So the type of stomata are known as that epistomatous condition. Generally, stomata are present, stomata are absent. But in some hydrophytic plants, which plants showing of that, okay, which in which plants leaves are exposed to that atmosphere, in that plants, okay, in that upper epidermis of leaf, stomata are present. They are involved in exchange of gases. They are present in that upper epidermis. That's why they are known as that epistomatous condition. Okay. Generally, cuticle is absent. But in some hydrophytes, okay, same as that in lotus, on that epidermis, a thin waxy layer is present. So this a thin waxy layer is okay, involved in that prevention of that water loss and protect to the plant from overheat. Okay, so that is known as that cuticle. Okay, after that parenchyma. So this, it means this absorption of water takes place throughout the surface of the plant body by the presence of thin wall cells. Okay, so in the parenchyma, air cavities are present. Okay, so it is involved in that exchange of gases, and also it providing buoyancy to that plant. Okay, it providing buoyancy to the plant. Buoyancy means plants able to float on the water, so that is known as that buoyancy. Okay, after that so parenchyma, next one is that so mechanical tissues are completely absent, because generally these hydrophytes, they do not affect to that stress and strain. That's why so mechanical tissues are completely absent. After that, okay, vascular tissues. In the vascular tissues, xylem is poorly developed. So because this absorption of water takes place by the complete throughout the surface of the plant body. Okay, that's why xylem is poorly developed. Okay, after that phloem is well developed. So that is known as that anatomical characters in hydrophytes. Anatomical characters in hydrophytes. Okay, so it is example for hydrilla TS of stem.